All-Star Wrestling is sanctioned by the AWA, the American Wrestling Association. All-Star Wrestling presents the top professional wrestlers from the United States, Canada, England, Germany, Australia, Mexico, Poland, Japan. The greatest professional wrestlers from throughout the world. And now to the ring for All-Star Action.
Fans, I want to tell you, we've got a lively crowd in the studio tonight, and well, we should. Starting it off, in the corner to my right, out of Atlanta, Georgia, he weighs in at 215 pounds, Rooster Griffin. Griffin. And his opponent, out of Mound, Minnesota, he weighs 217 pounds, one half of the High Flyers, Greg Gagne. Gagne, your referee, Marty Miller, this bout, one fall. Now down to Ron Trongard at ringside.
Standing room only. That's what we have here for this one. It's the Rooster out of Atlanta, Georgia, and Greg Gagne, one half of the former World Tag Team Champion High Flyers, both of them at 217 pounds. Greg, of course, out of Mound, Minnesota. There's a shoulder block by Greg Gagne and an arm drag takedown very quickly. Rooster Griffin ties his legs up in the rope, and referee Marty Miller says break, and Gagne, of course, does break clean. Wrist lock here by Rooster Griffin. And he uses the trunks. Marty Miller did not see that. He is questioning the Rooster, as you see, who, of course, vehemently denies that anything like that happened. And Vern, Greg Gagne, son of Vern, quickly turns the hold around and gets a hammerlock of his own, but too close to the ropes. And Rooster Griffin drapes that right arm over the lower rope strand and gets Gagne to break the hold. Greg Gagne, nice arm drag takedown there. As Griffin tried to work his way into a wrist lock, and Gagne saw it coming and had the momentum going and ripped his man to the canvas. Griffin has his legs over that bottom rope, and as you saw, Marty Miller. Monkey flip there. Marty Miller just kicked the legs away. One fall. Rooster Griffin from Atlanta, Georgia. Greg Gagne, Mound, Minnesota. Clean break by Gagne. Look at the moves by the young man out of Mound, Minnesota. He learned a lot of that from his dad, that's for sure, the former heavyweight champion of the world. In and out of trouble quickly, Gagne. And he has again the hammer lock on Rooster Griffin. Tremendous pressure on that elbow. Griffin trying to pick up Gagne. Doesn't do that, but you saw what he did. Right to the solar plexus. And there's an elbow smash. Gagne taking a bit of punishment here and now. The whip and across into the turnbuckle he goes. Takes a boot into the solar plexus. Gagne reverses the whip and sends Griffin into the turnbuckle and bombs away. Greg Gagne says, hey, enough is enough. The knee lift that just about knocks his man cold off the frontal lobe. Gagne grinds that right boot. That'll rearrange your thinking just a tad. Wrist lock here by Gagne, and you saw the Rooster grab the hair, and down to the canvas went one half of the High Flyers. What an expression on Griffin's face. Oh my. Griffin with an arm bar, Gagne threatening with the right hand, and again Griffin with the hair. and of course denying all along that he indeed did anything wrong. But Marty Miller saw it that time. Griffin breaks the hold quickly, but he's just as quickly back in again. Gagne up. Across the ring goes the Rooster. Gives Gagne a shoulder block. Watch this. Up and over goes Gagne. There is the flying drop kick. Gagne hit it perfectly. He does it again. He may have his man. A cover of one, two, and three. Gagne with a pair of flying drop kicks. And a cover and the pinfall over Rooster Griffin of Atlanta, Georgia. And let's take a look at it one more time, the way Gagne finished it off. A pair of beautiful flying drop kicks and then the cover for the pinfall. As you see, Gagne leave the arena.
Here's the brand new limited edition All the Best in 84 t-shirts. On the sleeves, the pictures of the greatest in all-star wrestling. Ideal for gift giving, they're tremendous. Here's what you do, send $10 to All Star Marketing. Post Office Box 35364, Minneapolis, Minnesota 55435. Allow 4 to 6 weeks for delivery. $10 gets it all the Best in 84.
Good morning, everybody. Here we go once again with another great hour of All-Star Wrestling. Boy, I tell you, they're really buzzing. Coming up Sunday, January 15th, St. Paul Civic Center. What a card promoter Wally Carbo has put together. Rock and Roll against Steve Regal. Jumping Jim Brunzell to meet superstar Billy Graham. Greg Gagne against Sheik Adnan El Casey. Tag team action. Billy Robinson, Brad Rangins against Jesse the Body Ventura and Mr. Saito. Baron Von Raschke to meet strongman Ken Patera. Black Jack Lanza to meet Bobby the Brain Heenan in that bunkhouse match. And Nick Bockwinkel and his partner Jerry Blackwell to meet the team of the one and only Crusher and Mad Dog Vachon. Greg Gagne, Jim Brunzell. Greg, you've got the Sheik in single action. I know it's not for the title, but yet you've wanted it him for a long, long time.
Match. We have been waiting for Sheik Adnan El Casey for a long time. Every time he has excuses that his arm is broken, he can't wrestle, doctors say he shouldn't be in the ring. Yet sitting on the outside of the ring, he can get up with that cast on his arm and wallop everybody. Well, Sheik, we're going to settle something that dates back to May of last year when you and Blackwell and Patera stole the titles from Jim and myself. When you reached into the ring with that cast on your arm and nailed Jim, you can come into that cast on your arm or anything else because nothing is going to save you this time. And that sounds like some strong talk, but that's the way I feel inside. You've cost Jim and I an awful lot. And in 1984, we're going to get it off to a real good start by eliminating one manager, Sheik Adnan El Casey. And I plan on doing that. If I get that sleeper hold on you, Sheik, think about this in the back of your mind. I don't care if the referee disqualifies me for not breaking up. I may hold on to that thing all night long.
Jim, you've got quite a customer and superstar, Billy Graham, somewhat of a legend around the AWA.
Well, that's right. Ken, you know, a lot of buddies of mine were at the gym talking, Andy Brown and Gene Cross and Joey Clark, and were asking about how Billy Superstar Graham compares now as what he did back in the AWA a number of years ago. And Billy Graham hasn't changed as far as his style. He's lost a little bit of weight. He's still very, very strong. And the key for me as far as being successful against him is I'm going to have to get him on his back and tire him out. And
now he's got the taekwondo.
That's right. You got to look out for the karate and the judo. And it's something that it's another little weapon for him. And hopefully, like I say, if I can get him down on his back and tire him out, maybe sting him with a couple of drop kicks, it'll put the odds in my favor.
Jim, very quickly, is it any different for you in your preparation going into a singles match as opposed to tag team with Greg?
Well, it's all mental. Physically, we still train the same way, but you'd have to say it's mental.
Fans, there you've got it. Stay with us. Don't go away. We'll be right back. Okay, boy, they're fired up now. Introducing out of Round Rock, Texas, he weighs 245 pounds, Craig Carson. Carson. And his opponent just coming into the ring area at 222 pounds. He hails from Fort Lauderdale, Florida. He is Steve Regal. Regal, one fall, your referee, Jim Mitchell.
Steve Regal, out of Fort Lauderdale, and Craig Carson from Round Rock, Texas. And immediately, Regal has got something to complain about to referee Jim Mitchell. Carson, just as quick as they come. Regal turns him around. Brings it to cleanly that time, but you're not going to see that much more, I don't believe, in this particular match. Regal. Carson felt the effects of that one. Right in the small of the back. Regal after the light heavyweight championship. Turnabout is fair play, says Craig Carson out of Round Rock, Texas. Carson with a 23-pound weight advantage over Regal. Regal complains to the referee, complains to the audience. And he gets a deaf ear from all concerned. Regal very quickly into a headlock. Regal, excellent, excellent wrestler. Hiplock takedown. Regal putting pressure on that headlock. That's what cauliflower ears are made of. You get a good close look there at the young man from Fort Lauderdale, Florida. Weighing in at 222 for this one. Rock and roll Buck Zumhoff, of course, is the light heavyweight champion of the world. Across he comes. The action is thick and fast. That one stung the back of Steve Regal. Regal saying Carson used the trunks, and Carson says no way. Mitchell also says no way. Carson says, come on, let's settle it right here in the center of the ring. Wrist lock by Steve Regal, putting the pressure on Craig Carson. See, will Regal break this one clean as he has been backed into the ropes? Carson not taking too highly to the antics and tactics of Steve Regal out of Fort Lauderdale, Florida. Again, Regal with his back to the ropes. Turns Carson around, and Carson uses his leg as a weapon. And over goes Regal. Maintaining to referee Jim Mitchell. That Carson used the hair. No way, young man, no way. Again, the hookup. Now to the corner. Regal fires away and Carson fires back. Carson with a whip across. Oh, my! Regal get out of the way just in time. Carson took the blow of that into the top turnbuckle on his head. Here is the suplex by Regal. And this will stun you very, very quickly. Let's see if he gets a quick cover, a quick count, and it's three. That suplex will stun you. And that's exactly what it did to Craig Carson, who lost track of it all just long enough for Regal to put on the cover and claim the first fall in this 2 out of 3 fall match.
wrestling fans, on Tuesday, January the 17th at Mayo Civic Auditorium in Rochester, Minnesota, you'll see your television favorite wrestlers, Blackjack Lanza, Rock and Roll Zumhoff, Nick Bockwinkel, Bobby the Brain Heenan, plus many, many more. Get your tickets in advance at Mayo Civic Auditorium.
There's a time in life for the youngest.
At the Twin Cities, they're still talking about that rather unlikely alliance that has developed between heavyweight champion Nick Bockwinkel and big, big Jerry Blackwell teaming up to meet Mad Dog Vachon and the Crusher. Nick Bockwinkel, if you will, certainly unexpected, to say the least, you and Jerry Blackwell.
Well, not quite. In fact, I'll tell you what I'd like to do. Mr. Blackwell and I will not be together. Instead, it's going... Easy. I've got something that I'd like the people to see. If they could bring it up on the monitor, and could we show this next segment, please?
Gunslingers, bounty hunters, mercenaries, you name it. The gentleman with me right now is for hire. He's a paid assassin, Blackjack Mulligan, and he's coming to Minnesota.
Well, you see, for the people of Minnesota that don't understand who I am and where I'm coming from, what you're looking at, see, we don't even acknowledge Minnesota in West Texas. Because we thought you folks had canceled football up there. We don't even understand what's happening. So for your information, you trivia fans, what you're looking at is one-third of the greatest wrestling team ever assembled, undefeated, undisputed world tag team champions of all time. Blackjack Mulligan, brother. 6'7", 310 pounds. The heavy one-third of the team that carried us to sell out crowds unequaled in the sport of wrestling. Lanza, I don't know what your problem is. The call come down. Mulligan, there's something going on in Minnesota. Lanza is gone walking the line, book carrying. Something like that that we don't understand. Lanza, that'll be dealt with on another day. Bobby Heenan has asked me to do a job. And, brother, they have called the man that'll do it without any question. Nick Bockwinkel and myself are going in the ring against Mad Dog Vachon and the Crusher. And you see, Mad Dog, I am not in awe of you and the Crusher one bit. Because I am afraid of no man alive. And the job I have been asked to do is destroy the Crusher and Mad Dog all in one swipe. And you ever put your creepy hands on Bobby Heenan again, Mad Dog Vachon and Crusher, I'll break every bone in your body, and you'll never be able to bite, scratch, kick, fight, or talk ever again. Did I make myself clear?
Nick, he's been banned from half the cities around.
For those people who might not know or who were too awestruck, that is Blackjack Mulligan, a former member of the Heenan family. Now, Blackjack Mulligan is about 6'7" or 6'8", weighs about 345 pounds. He is big, he is nasty, he is rough, he is vicious. And this man and I are going to team up. Now, I never thought I'd be a 245-pound little weakling, but that's probably what I'll look like alongside of Mr. Mulligan. And Mr. Mulligan and I are going to go into that ring. And Mad Dog Vachon and the Crusher, I want to know something. I want you to know something. 1984 is going to be a lousy year for the two of you. It's really going to be bad. You know why it's going to be bad? Because it's going to start off right in St. Paul. Because when that gentleman and myself, the world's heavyweight champion, standing here talking to you, and when that monster, that giant, who is a nasty, nasty, big, rugged, vicious man, and myself get through with the two of you, then I will venture to say, you two will be on the shelf for the year.
Fans, you talk about a bombshell. I can't believe it. Without a doubt, the nastiest man in all of professional wrestling. It all comes to pass Sunday, January 15th, at St. Paul Civic Center, 8 p.m. In addition, Jim Brunzell to meet superstar Billy Graham, Greg Gagne to meet The Sheik, Benny Robinson, Brad Rangins against Ventura and Saito, Blackjack Lanza to meet Bobby Heenan in that bunkhouse match, and as you've just heard, Nick Bockwinkel and big, big Blackjack Mulligan to meet Mad Dog Vachon and the Crusher. Mad Dog Crusher, I still can't believe where I thought Mulligan had been banned.
Well, obviously, Nick Bockwinkel is scared to death because he knows darn well that Blackjack Mulligan is going to be right in front of him, and he's going to be hiding in the back. And he knows that Jerry Fatwell cannot do the job, although he was 500 pounds. Because with the Crusher and I, nobody can do the job. And I don't care if it's Blackjack Mulligan or anyone else. Mick Buckwinkle, your number is up, and you're shaking in your boots because you're trying to get the biggest man in wrestling. 6'8" or 9", 345 pounds. Blackjack Mulligan.
That's sure.
But you're going to get beat.
What a yellow bum that Blackwell was. I didn't think he had the guts to show up. So now he went and got this big giant. I'm surprised he didn't go get a robot. But me and Mad Dog, we know how to whittle them big bums down to size. We'll have that guy the size of the midget, the little bruiser.
Crusher, I still can't believe it. Fans, it all comes to pass they Sunday the 15th.
We're not talking about it.
That's a dog. I'm
not
going
to whittle that.
Third, but it now reads Sunday night, January 15th, the St. Paul Civic Center, Nick Bockwinkle and his real partner, Blackjack Mulligan, to meet the team of Crusher and Mad Dog Vachon. In addition to that big bunkhouse match, Blackjack lands in to meet Bobby the Brain Heenan. And somewhat of a surprise, gentlemen, if you will, Brad Rangins and Billy Robinson. Now, you two, last time out, battled to quite a match, one of the best scientific matches I've seen in quite a while, but yet here you are now joining forces.
Well, let's say this. We tried each other out last time, and it was certainly a test. I came back never thinking that this man would give me the match he did. And it's the toughest match I've had anywhere at any time. The men were wrestling Saito, who is very, very good wrestler. Adept at the karate and Eastern styles of arts, and of course you've got the strongman Ventura. But I do believe that a combination of Brad and myself together can beat them. And now, we're not coming out here screaming and shouting. We're coming out just stating fact. To me, Brad is the toughest man I've ever wrestled. And I think the combination between the two of us will be more than enough for Saito and Jesse Ventura.
Brad Rangins, I don't mind telling you, even though you and Billy have yet to step in the ring together, this tag team combination of yours already raising a great many eyebrows around the AWA.
Well, Ken, I just want to say, after wrestling against Billy Robinson, I've gained a lot of respect, and I know now what the promoters and everyone out there, when they say Billy Robinson is a man of 1,000 holds, he is a man of 2,000 holds. And I know with his international experience and my international experience, we're the better team, and we're going to come out the victors.
Well, certainly a match I'm looking forward to seeing. Billy Robinson, Brad Rangins. Buck Rock and Roll, come on
hey,
in.
Hey, Ken. You know, Steve Regal, he's making his appearance in the AWA again. Well, let me tell you something, Regal. Right from downtown Hamburg, Minnesota, at Chef Bar, they're taking a bus. And they're going to come right down, and when that first bus is full, Ken, they're going to bring two buses, three buses, and they're going to be chanting rock and roll. And all the people in the Minneapolis area, in the cities here, they're going to be chanting rock and roll. So, Regal, when you get in the ring with me, baby, keep your ears open. Keep your eyes open, Daddy, because we're going to rock and roll.
All right, Buck, thank you. Fans, stay with us. We'll be right back. Don't you dare go away. I like that.
Don't forget, wrestling fans, at New Ulm, Minnesota, at Cathedral High School, on Friday, January the 13th, you will see in action the Crusher, the one and the only Crusher, who made Milwaukee famous, the Sheik, Mr. Saito, Jesse the Body Ventura, plus many, many more of your favorite TV wrestlers. Advance tickets available at Green Clothiers. Get them right now. Don't forget, Friday, at New Ulm, Minnesota, Cathedral High School, on Friday, January 13th.
All right, introducing first at 240 pounds, he hails from Southeast Missouri, he is the Black Panther. His opponent, one of the strongest men in all of wrestling, out of Portland, Oregon, at 280 pounds, one half of the World Tag Team Champions, Ken Patera. Patera. Second, as always, by his manager out of Baghdad, Iraq, Sheik Adnan El-Kissi. The referee, Jim Mitchell. Now down to Rod Trongard.
Sheik Adnanel Casey, always having a few extra words to say to just about anybody. Jim Mitchell, the referee, in this instance, is his choice. Ken Patera, feeling his garments and ready to go. Jim Mitchell says, ring the bell, so let's do that very thing, and we're officially underway. The Black Panther giving away 40 pounds to Ken Patera. And Ken, of course, as Ken Resnick said in the introduction, one of the strongest in the world, bench pressing over 500 pounds. Talking now to the crowd. Ken Patera and Sheik Ayatollah Jerry Blackwell, the AWA Tag Team Champions of the World. But right now, Patera in a little bit of a fix as the Black Panther has him in a headlock, but Patera forces him to the ropes. And there's a forearm smash to the pectoral muscles, and Patera with a takedown. The Black Panther flail kicks his way out. Now starts after Sheik Adnan LKC, manager of the tag team champions. The Black Panther. All we know about him is he's from Southeast Missouri. Ken Patera quickly to work on that left arm. Arm bar, twisting it around. Now the top rope strand firing away onto the deltoid muscle on top of that shoulder. And now the whip across the ring. Oh, wow. He bounces off that turnbuckle just like a rubber ball off a brick wall. The Black Panther in trouble. Patera picking him up. The backbreaker. Down he comes. A cover and a count of two. Patera again to work on him. He will bounce him off the canvas. And there's the flying elbow smash. And again the cover. Two count. Patera off the second rope with the double arm hammer into the middle of the back. Actually right at the base of the neck. Patera. The suplex. Down comes 240 pounds of Black Panther, covered by 280 pounds of Patera, and a three count, and this one is all over very, very quickly. Ken Patera, one half of the AWA World Tag Team Champions. Patera pinning the Black Panther using elbow smashes, a double arm hammer off the second rope, and then the suplex. And it was just too much for the Black Panther. As you can see,
here's brand new limited edition, all the best in 84 t-shirts. On the sleeves, the pictures of the greatest in all-star wrestling. Ideal for gift giving, they're tremendous. Here's what you do, send $10 to All Star Marketing. Post Office Box 35364, Minneapolis, Minnesota 55435. Allow 4 to 6 weeks for delivery. $10 gets it all the best in 84.
Fans, be certain to pick up your copy of the latest issue of Major League Wrestling, the official program of the AWA, chock full of pictures and stories about all the great stars. Rumored to be read by such luminaries as Dr. Jerry Poland, Governor Rudy Perpich, Bill Ferret out at Eastside Beverage, Senator Rudy Boswitz, Frankie and Billy Bedore, and Dick Heeb. Major League Wrestling, the official program of the AWA. Former world champion Vern Gagne. Everyone's still buzzing about Nick Bockwinkel's bombshell, if you will, of bringing in Black Jack Mulligan.
Well, he's a big one, all right, and at 6'7" and about 340 or 50 pounds, whatever he is, it is a big one, no doubt about it, and the boys are going to have their handful. That's Crusher and the Dog. I would just, Ken, like to say something about our new football coach at the University of Minnesota, Lou Holtz, and, of course, the great job that the search committee, headed up by Billy Bye, Mike Wright, and others, and, of course, the great president of our university, President McGraw, and the great, it really did Paul Giel's heart good, I think, the fact that that this was done, and we got the personality and the coach that we have, and that's Lou Holtz. And I think he's just going to do a fantastic job, but it's going to just our congratulations to that whole search committee, the Regents, Irv Goldfein, and all the people involved there. I think it's going to be a great united effort here in the state of Minnesota to get the football at the University of Minnesota back where it was and has been in the past. And I think it couldn't have happened at a better time to pick this gentleman we got, Lou Holtz.
And
thank
what
you.
A tremendous name. Thank you very much. Black Jack Lanza, I know you have been waiting.
Before you say something, I'm just going to say this right real quick for you. Black Jack Mulligan and I have held world championships together, and I'm not going to concern myself with he and what Bockwinkel and Heenan have come up with. I'm not interested in that. The only thing that's interesting me is the Weasel Heenan in a bunkhouse match. Now, the bunkhouse match is specifically designed to keep Mr. Weasel in the ring, because there will be 12 to 15 wrestlers outside the ring, and the Weasel will be dressed up like a cowboy. And when the Weasel gets it in his mind to take a little walk to leave the ring like he does constantly, the wrestlers will pick him up, throw him bodily right back in the ring. And Weasel, I'll be waiting there for you. So when you hit the ring, you're not going to go anywhere but down in defeat, because this is one match you'll never forget.
Remember the night, Sunday, January 15th, St. Paul Civic Center. Don't go away. We'll be right back. All right, we've got one for you now. Tag team action. Wally Carbo. All right, ladies and gentlemen, this match scheduled to be introducing first at 225 pounds out of Cleveland, Ohio, Kenny Sodbuster J. His partner, his tag team partner, scheduled to be Buddy Lane out of Portland, Oregon. Due to problems with plane connections, he could not be here. Taking his place at 270 pounds, the Republic of Germany, the great Baron von Raske. Von Raske. I'll tell you, their opponents, known as the Far East-West Connection, introducing first at 255 pounds, out of Tokyo, Japan, the great Japanese star, the master of the martial arts, Mr. Saito. Saito. And his partner.
Rename Mr. Saito Mr. Torture.
Mr. Torture. And his partner at 280 pounds. Out of San Diego, California, the body, Jesse Ventura. Ventura, your referee, Marty Miller.
You know, for all the people that didn't see on television, I'm going to show you just how bad, how rugged, and what a torture man my main man, Mr. Saito.
What are you talking about?
I'm going to put on, Mr. Saito and I are going to put on a little demonstration before this match.
All right, fans, evidently a demonstration coming up between Mr. Saito, Mr. Torture, if you will, and Jesse Ventura. Wait. Another. Again, I've never seen anything.
Just watched Mr. Saito split three boards in two that were held by Jesse the Body Ventura, and immediately he goes to work on Kenny J. Kenny the Sodbuster J. out of Cleveland and Northeast Minneapolis. And a tag off here to Jesse the Body Ventura comes in. But very, very quickly, Kenny J goes to work on Jesse the Body, who has named he and Mr. Saito as the Far East-West Connection. And the Baron Von Raschke, drives a knee to the midsection of Jesse Ventura, who crawls to the corner and tags off, and in comes the 247 man from the Far East, Mr. Saito, who, as you have heard, Jesse the Body labeled Mr. Torture. And he immediately goes to work on the man from the Republic of Germany, Baron Von Raschke. 280 pounds for the Baron, but he is feeling the effects of the karate of Mr. Saito. There's a snap there, and there is a karate thrust to the throat. The Baron fires back a hard right hand to the jaw, and then across the back, and an Irish whip across the ring. Here's the back body drop, and the Baron had him 6.5 to 7 feet in the air. The elbow smash. Baron Von Raschke aroused, and now he goes and drives Mr. Saito's head into the knee of Kenny J, tags off, and now both Baron Von Raschke and Kenny J are working on Mr. Saito, who saw Kenny J coming. Single leg takedown by Mr. Saito on Kenny J, and the tag off, and the boot to the solar plexus by Jesse the Body Ventura at 280 pounds out of San Diego, California. They've got Kenny J wrapped up in that top rope over there. Jesse the Body Ventura hammering away with the boot. Kenny J hanging there helpless. Baron Von Raschke trying to help. He's chased by Marty Miller. And Mr. Saito has tagged off and has come in. And he tagged back off with Jesse the Body Ventura. All this time, Kenny J in an absolutely helpless upside-down position, as you see. Marty Miller is going to have to stop this. Baron Von Raschke crashes Marty Miller into Mr. Saito. The Baron has had enough. And now he drives Saito into Jesse the Body Ventura. He clubs Ventura with a right hand. Picks up Mr. Saito. The atomic drop on Mr. Saito. The Baron is absolutely gone berserk. Tries to throw, or looks like he was going to throw Saito out of the ring on one side. Then he takes him across the other way and rifles him out. Now he goes to work on Jesse the Body Ventura. A snapmare brings Ventura back into the ring. Kenny J is still hanging upside down out of view of your screen. Baron Von Raschke driving the head of Jesse the Body Ventura into the top turnbuckle. And all this time, Kenny J cannot extricate himself. And Marty Miller cannot take time to do it for him. The claw on Jesse the Body Ventura. Miller now trying to loosen Kenny J, and he gets the sodbuster free. All this time, the Baron with a powerful hand, and Marty Miller says, ring the bell. This one is all over. Kenny J may be seriously hurt. Mr. Saito crushes the board onto the head of Baron Von Raschke and knocks him absolutely cold. What is going on here, ladies and gentlemen? Baron Von Raschke flat on his face in the ring. You see the blood coming out of the left temple and down across the left eye of Baron Von Raschke, and Jesse the Body Ventura continues to work on him. And here is the inverted body vice. The inverted body vice, and down on the throat with a karate or judo chop. Oh, the Baron is one bloody mess in that ring. Jesse the Body Ventura has thrown referee Marty Miller across the ring, and Marty Miller is out of it. The Baron bleeding profusely. Jesse the Body Ventura and Mr. Saito continue to work him over. Marty Miller has come back and is trying to stop this thing in one way or another, and wrestlers come in now to help Baron Von Raschke. However, they're being thrown out of the ring by Jesse the Body Ventura and Mr. Saito just as quickly as they come in. Ladies and gentlemen, here comes Jimmy Blundell, and he takes care of first
Jesse the Body Ventura. And now, Mr. Saito, look at that flying drop kick. Look at it, a boot-to-the midsection of Jesse the Body Ventura and a flying drop kick for Jesse the Body. Jimmy Brunzell has gone berserk as he comes to the aid of his friend Baron Von Raschke and Kenny J, both lying helpless on the floor. Look out. Jim Brunzell takes a handful of salt from Mr. Saito. His eyes are full of salt. He is blinded. And now Jesse the Body Ventura and Mr. Saito will go to work on him. They've got to do something to stop this, ladies and gentlemen. The inverted body vice with Jimmy Brunzell on the shoulder of Jesse the Body Ventura. And now here is Greg Gagne coming in to aid his partner Jimmy Brunzell. And Gagne fires away at Saito. Out he goes. And he goes to work on Jesse the Body Ventura. And out he goes. Three injured wrestlers in this match, ladies and gentlemen. Kenny J. I can't believe it. Baron Von Raschke. And Jim Brunzell, who could take it no longer, and he came to the aid of Von Raschke and Mr. Saito. Von Raschke's head is just a mass of blood after he took the board across the skull from Mr. Saito. And Jimmy Brunzell is still blinded. Wally Carbo has now come out. Wally Carbo coming into the ring, the promoter, to check on Baron Von Raschke. This is the worst I have ever seen. Jimmy Brunzell blinded, being aided from the ring by Jim Mitchell. Something is going to have to be done about Jesse the Body Ventura. And as he calls him, Mr. Torture, Mr. Saito, the Far East West connection. They're not going to let something like this go on. Greg Gagne, Marty Miller, Wally Carbo, other attendants here at ringside, helping a badly, badly beaten, as you can see, Baron Von Raschke out of the ring. Oh, my. Absolutely the worst I have ever seen. You get another look now, and here comes Mr. Saito crashing the board across the skull of Baron Von Raschke, and down he goes, opening a gash over that left eye. Absolutely unbelievable, unreal, the worst thing that I have ever seen. Now, quickly, let's go to ringside, and Ken?
Wally, please, Wally. What in the world? Twice. First, the trophy with Hulk months ago, and now absolutely no written. Brutal.
I don't know what got into Saito and his new partner, Jesse the Body Ventura, but that big Japanese Saito has started his trend of wrestling. I know he's a rough, tough customer, but he's not going to get away of crippling these wrestlers unfairly. Now, tonight, he has hurt Baron Von Raschke and Jim Brunzell. At the moment, I do not know how bad those two wrestlers are hurt. Now, I don't know what he's trying to prove, his point or his style of wrestling, but I'm going to tell you something. He is not going to get away with it. At the moment, I don't know what I'm going to do. But I'm going to fight fire with fire, and I've got some ideas when I get a chance to start to do some thinking of how to punish this Saito. I will do it.
The match is over. I know it.
Nope. This is not the end of it for you two guys.
Don't you run off on me, Caribou. Let me tell you something.
The match was over. There was no reason.
There was plenty of reason. Mr. Saito, Mr. Torture, and myself, we're not breaking any rules. What? The man was tied. The man was tied on the ropes. We're tagging in and out legally. And then what happens? The Baron Von Raschke comes running in the ring, gloves Mr. Saito, throws him out of the ring, illegally brings me into the ring, puts a claw onto me. And let me tell you something. And this is a warning for anybody, anywhere, that messes with the Far East West connection. That's mild compared to what we're gonna do. Mr. Torture is made for this. And as for you, Caribou, I've dealt with you. I've had your suspensions. You remember back a couple years ago, Caribou, when you got your coat ripped right off your back. Well, that just might happen to you again. And as for jumping Jim Brunzell, who comes running in, Greg Gagne comes running in, High Criers, you ain't never messed with nobody like the Far East West Connection, Jack.
Jesse, the match remains.
Don't you tell me nothing.
We are Mr. Jimmy. You love that, David.
You value the coach. I'll rip it off of you. I'll rip it off of you, Caribou. Ain't nobody.
Greg, please. We'll mess with these fellas. Now, Jim is back there and has salt in his eyes. Baron Von Rasch gets a severe cut on his head, but a severe injury is to his throat. Whatever Saito did coming off that top rope, as far as we're concerned, and their status is going for championships, there's no way. We want Ventura and Saito. We'll settle this thing with them. Whether it's here, same problem. We don't.
Fans, I still can't believe it. You saw it. The match was over totally without reason. There's nothing more I could say. Have a good week. We'll see you again next time with more, I'm sure. So long. Bye.
You have been watching All-Star Wrestling, featuring the finest professional wrestlers. All-Star Wrestling is sanctioned by the AWA, the American Wrestling Association, and produced by the Minneapolis Boxing and Wrestling Club. Executive producer, Vern Gagne. Wally Carbo, promoter. Directed by Tom Scott. Produced by Al DeRuscia. This has been a sports presentation of Athletic Matchmakers Incorporated.